Of course.
Heard enough.
This threatens all of us now.
She's right. We've got to fight together.
See, Darien, she'll tell ya. We can stop them.
If she's seen them, she knows better. Something killed a whole crew of hunters out in the wood. Tore them apart like dolls, insects.
Something like the creatures that attacked my fort, perhaps?
I told ya! All we gotta do is get him in range of these cannons and then we blast them!
We don't even know what they are!
I came to offer my clan's help. The White March has been our home for centuries. We'll defend it alongside you. Sound it anywhere in the White March, and three of my best warriors will be at your side. Your battles become ours.
What's your plan for dealing with them exactly?
That lake's notorious. Folk never come back from that. Oh.
You'll need all the help you can get. I have fewer men to offer than I would like, but the Iron Flail stands ready. Our siege weapons are at your disposal.
The same ones you threw at the battery's walls?
These Eyeless will come for us all if they aren't stopped here and now.
Forget it. You're not bringing your army into our backyard. Tell him. I guess you're right. Won't be anything left of Stalwart if we don't stop these monsters anyway.
Ahem. me out. Kaerin's scar should be just in range for those guns. You just point out your target and I'll do the rest.
If those things are on the move, we don't have much time. If you're really gonna stop them, take this. It's the best of the ore we've pulled from Stalwart's mines. It's not much, but it's good enough to make the old Pargrunan smiths proud. I'm sorry about what I said before. Just don't take it out on the rest of the village.
As you wish. Keeping an eye out. blade in the dark. Keeping an eye out. Bring them down! I see something. A blade in the dark. As you wish.
Thank you.
Of course. Keeping an eye out. Keeping an eye out. Where there's a pick, there's a way. I'll see it done. It's finished. Keeping an eye out. Keeping an eye out. Let's go. A blade in the dark.
A blade in the dark.
Keeping an eye out. They won't see me coming.
Kill them all!
Keeping an eye out.
Bring them down!
They won't see me coming.
No prisoners!
A blade in the dark. Of course. A blade in the dark. Of course. Keeping an eye out. As you wish.
But I do not wish to give false hope. The greater challenge remains in front of you. Running through the core of this rock is a large growth of crystal. You will know it when you see it. A blow to the crystal would reverberate through the walls of this place. Strike it enough and the entire structure would crumble. The eyeless would be buried. Of course, it would take a person years to cause enough damage. Then you know what must be done. Strike the crystal with Abaddon's hammer. The eyeless will wake and come to its call. Join in striking the crystal. They will cluster together and bury themselves. I have realized it is best that they should be ended, for within each of them is a small piece of Abaddon himself. Upon their deaths, those fragments and the memories they contain will be safely dispersed. A single strike upon the crystal will not be enough. The eyeless respond only as long as the hammer rings. You will need to remain until their work is complete, wielding the hammer until the walls come crumbling down. It is a difficult thing to accept that one's dying day has already been marked. It is good that you have no illusions about your own. The Eyeless cannot be reasoned with or fled from. One day not far from now, they would kill you and level the Deerwood. And the truth is that you are marked by the Eyeless for a reason. It would be better for all if the things you have seen were forgotten.
They won't see me. A blade in the dark. Well? As you wish. Keeping an eye out. They won't see me coming. As you wish.
Thank you. blasphemy! These are jewels of civilization. They are sacred. We would sooner sacrifice our own bodies than dislodge a single stone from such a place. Why do you torment us with baseless accusations? Then we were betrayed. A part of ourselves was cut away. And we were made to betray something we cherish. The bedrock of civilization. Better for her tides to ebb and her seas to dry up than to cover a single stone the Ingwithans laid. Each culture builds on the bones of the last, yet many only look up at where they would go, never down at the foundations that bear them. Like a mason who builds a listing tower. What peril do they inflict on their progeny, and what dishonor on their forebears? It is unwise to douse a lamp in darkness, to cut the legs from a table. This forgetting is suicide, heresy. Every advance in the crafts and institutions of Kith was forged by skill and sacrifice. A people cut off from their history will wither. They deserve no less. A path that leads in circles. That is why we must return to ourself and restore Abaddon. A facile argument. One that defends stasis, not progress. Do not condemn knowledge when it becomes inconvenient for you. Just as fire clears dead wood from a forest, struggle makes way for new developments. Conflict is part of progress. Peace and ignorance is not worth keeping. Do not condemn knowledge when it becomes inconvenient for you. And we have listened. When Ioni Brotha fell, Abaddon lost much. His will to preserve, the memory of how and why he died. but he built us with fragments of his own soul. In returning, we can restore what was taken from him. We shall see this world and its people restored.
The Eyeless disappeared beneath the lake, their bond to Andra finally severed. With this threat ended, hope returned to the White March. Hunters returned to the wildernesses, and travelers to the roads. Tales of the Watcher's bravery replaced stories of monsters in the woods. The villagers of Stalwart busied their hands with work and their tongues with song, eager to seize on the promise of peace.